Ryan Thomas with EastWest here, and I'm so excited to finally be able to share something that's been in the works for a while now. This is the new EastWest String Machine, and it's a fusion of several legendary vintage string machines with modern samples and ease of playability. So you can recreate iconic string machine sounds using samples that were meticulously recorded from hardware units like the Roland Jupiter 6 or the ARP Solina, among others. Now, you could also apply a vintage-modeled ensemble chorus to some of the modern samples to achieve a sound similar to the old ARP Solina, but with a richer, more complex sound. And of course, you can mix the vintage analog string machines with the modern samples to just create these massive patches like the Deity preset. Now, Deity is only one of over a dozen massive presets that were programmed by our own Nick Phoenix. Next, let's check out The Forest, and this one has a bit more of a mellow vibe to it. This next one is called Final Judgment, and it's got just an absolutely huge, rich sound. So you can imagine just how insane that one would sound even in a live setting. Next up, let's give a listen to Fat Tire Space Rider. And the low end on that one is just so incredibly fat. So let's check out a few more of these presets, and then we'll demo some of the individual sound sources and talk about the instrument controls. So this next one is called Heavens. And this next one is called Tokyo String Machine, and it's just got a really ear-pleasing edge to it at all dynamic levels. All right, let's try one more. This one is called Winds of Change, and it's a bit more on the darker side. All right, so let's quickly talk about the interface and the controls. So String Machine has four modules. You've got the vintage module with all the actual string machines and the vintage analog synth pads, the modern sampled strings, the woodwinds and brass, and then of course the vocals. Now the key colors are just showing which modules are active, with the white keys indicating range overlap. And of course all these sources stack, which gives you so much more creative power than any of the old string machines or software emulations, not to mention the vastly improved sound quality of the orchestral samples. Now, each sound source also has an alternative version, which is based on an entirely different set of samples, so you just have so many different options here. So these are the 60s strings. And then these are the 60s strings alternative. And I think the 70s strings and the 80s strings alt stacked together make this really vibey classic string machine sound. As you might have already noticed, one of the more unique features of this string machine is that the mod wheel is actually crossfading between several different dynamic layers, giving the EastWest String Machine a modern expressive touch that no other string machine has ever had. And let's fatten this sound up even more by adding pad A. And this was actually sampled from a vintage hardware synth. Now, the chorus and the ensemble chorus are modeled after the ARP Solina and the Roland Jupiter 6, so they're kind of a hybrid of the two. And they just add such a fat presence to the sound. So here is the chorus. And here's the ensemble chorus. Now, there is also a stereo field widener. And then, of course, an EQ filter that is mapped by default to CC11. So here is that filter in action. Now there are four reverbs that you can turn on or off using these tabs, and they all stack. You can adjust the send levels using these knobs up here. So let's go ahead and explore the individual sound sources so that you can have a better idea of all the options you have with String Machine. And we're gonna start with the 70 strings since we've already heard both versions of the 60 strings. And I think those just have such a fat sound even by themselves. They just have that great classic vintage sound. So here are the 70s strings alt. And then here are the 80s strings. Those ones just scream 80s to me. And then here are the 80s alt strings. And now we're into the pads, and these were all beautifully sampled from some vintage hardware synths. So this is pad A. This is pad A alt. And this is pad B. This is pad B in the alt mode. And that one just has such a huge sound. This is pad C. And then pad C in the alt mode. So again, this isn't just another run-of-the-mill string machine emulation. It's an encyclopedia of several legendary string machines that can be used by themselves to create that classic string machine sound, or that can be used in conjunction with other vintage samples, or that can also be fused with modern samples to create these massive, lush patches. So again, no one has done anything quite like this before. Okay, now let's hear all the modern strings together. And these are the strings in the alt mode, which is going to remove the vibrato. And that can be desirable depending on the sound that you're going for. So you can just consider the quality of the orchestral samples from the old string machine synth combos. And obviously there's just no comparison to the EastWest string machine. Okay, let's check out the woodwinds and the brass. So we will start with the woodwinds. And here are the woodwinds in the alt mode. And this is just going to remove the vibrato. And then here is the brass. And you can just hear that insane dynamic range. And here are the brass in the alt mode. And here is a great preset that is going to give you a good idea of the brass in context. So here is Heart of Arpness. Now, the vocals all consist of modern choir and solo vocal samples, so they're going to sound absolutely incredible and have a ton of dynamic layers. So here is the men's choir. And here's the men's choir in the alt mode. And this is just going to change the articulation to an ah. And here's the women's choir. And here's the women's choir in the alt mode, again, changing that articulation to an ah. And here is the solo female vocalist. And I think this just has such a great vibe to it. And here is the solo female vocals in the alt mode. This also has a really cool vibe. I think it would work well in a hip hop context or something along those lines. All right, so this is a preset that features at least something from all of the modules, so you can get a good sense of how these are all working together in context. This is the Vintage Orchestra preset. So again, no one's really done anything quite like this before. There have been some virtual string machines in the past, but nothing involving the variety of string machines that were sampled for the EastWest String Machine, along with all the modern samples working together in one highly intuitive interface. As you saw, the playing experience is just really smooth. It's absolutely superb. And all of these patches are just highly playable. Obviously, there is so much more to explore with this instrument, which you can do if you're a Composer Cloud Plus subscriber, as this is automatically included in your subscription. It's also, of course, available as a one-time purchase. So if you liked this content, don't forget to like the video, comment, subscribe, and hit that notification bell. That's all for now. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.